This is the parts list for the space-time simulator, and so stay tuned and I'm going to show you how to go about putting them all together.
Okay, here are all the parts for the space-time simulator. I've got sorted round objects here. I've got some clips. I've got a 100-inch by 100-inch piece of Lycra. And chances are you will have to sew that together. It doesn't come in rolls that wide, and so that's not a big deal. Just sew it together. You'll have a seam, and the seam doesn't really show that much. Also, make sure you get four-way stretch Lycra, so it should stretch both directions, and they call it four-way stretch. And then I have a set of PVC pieces, both regular PVC and electrical conduit PVC, and we'll look at that in some more detail. Okay, here's a exploded set of the PVC pieces. There are two duplicates. This would be one segment of the drum shape that you're gonna see me make in a little bit. So let's get a little closer. And you can also see a cross of meter sticks in the middle so you can get a rough idea of the scale. And so these are the vertical pieces on the drum shape. There is a T connector that's glued to a piece of just regular PVC and an identical piece at the top. And then the other pieces, that is gray electrical conduit. It's PVC electrical conduit. It's a little flexible, and so it allows itself to be bent into a round shape. And then another coupler that is glued onto it. And then on the other end, there's another piece that's glued on. And so when we assemble this, this piece just goes in, and it doesn't go all the way usually, some of them do, and it's just held in place by friction. That lets you take things apart and store it easily. And so in this picture here, this T coupling is glued onto the PVC. This coupler is glued onto the electrical conduits. But this just slips in kind of like a tinker toy. The exact pieces you get aren't important as long as you can fit them together like this. I do give the part numbers on the document that you can download, but the best thing to do is just go to the hardware store and make a big tinker toy set like this. Okay, now I'm getting ready to assemble it. It does help to have somebody assist you, but I'm going to show you can do it all by yourself in case you're doing this in the morning, nobody's around. And so you can see the PVC with the T couplers glued on the ends and the electrical PVC conduit with the couplers glued on the ends. And I'm about ready to fasten those together. And if you look, you'll see that there are seven of the PVC pipes that are the vertical segments of the drum shape and a corresponding 14 of the gray electrical conduit PVC pieces with the couplers glued to their ends. Okay, now I'm going to put this thing together. I've slipped the pieces into their couplings, and so it's just this long chain you saw before, just friction holding the couplers to the T-couplers, and I'm just going to grab this end and carefully bend it up, watching the ceiling. Don't bend it any more than you have to. I'm going to reach down and grab this side. Be careful not to trip over things. And then now all I have to do is get one of these couplers into the T coupling here. And it should hold with just a friction. Again, be careful not to bend these too much. The gray things are bendable, but they do get brittle over time. And over the 10 years I've replaced about half mine, they'll just break eventually. But not today. And so now, if I turn this over, you can see I have a large drum shape, and all I need to do now is drape the spandex or Lycra over this and clamp it. So I'm going to do that now, and then I'll talk a little bit about adjusting that. Okay, finally, just want to make sure the thing is working. So have it at a certain tautness. I just kind of come up with this over time that this looks like a good way to start, but let's test it out. So I'm assuming you've seen the video showing you how to use it with students. These are two large ball bearings. They're just made out of steel, nothing special. They're not magnets, and they're sold by Arbor Scientific. And so just go to Arbor Scientific and search colliding steel spheres. And they're good for a whole lot of other things if you're a physics teacher or even chemistry teacher. So I'll let you find that out from Arbor. And one thing I want to do is make sure when I put them on the space-time simulator that they show that they're attracted to each other. And that works. So that's good enough. The other thing that's more sensitive to how much it's adjusted is if you want to show the figure eight sort of lunar trajectory. And so in this case, I use 2 kilogram masses. I can probably get other ones to work, but these I found work pretty well. When I put them on, I noticed some of my seam is coming open, so I'll sew that up before I use this in class, but it'll work for this. And then I just take a marble, or you can use a small steel ball bearing. I should be able to get it to go around both objects in a figure eight if it's adjusted right, and that's pretty good. And so it's not easy to get that to happen. Here's a metal one. That worked a little better. And here's another marble. And so it doesn't work every time, but you should be able to get it to work without a lot of frustration. Yeah, that might have been the best time it worked ever. And so I highly recommend making one of these and using it with your students. Very engaging, gets them curious about probably one of the greatest achievements of modern science, the general theory of relativity, and also just knowing about gravity and orbits is pretty cool.